today I wanted to tell you guys about some Dropbox things I realized. And that would be that my Dropbox was taking up almost half my processor. I've got a quad-core processor, and it was taking up 150 CPU, so that means it was taking up 1.5 cores. That would explain there why my computer was so slow. I mean, come on, it would lag, and you go to Safari, and I got to look in the activity monitor. There's a table down there. It says active applications under system activities, I believe it says. And you go there, and it says Dropbox, CPU, 150. Wow. I got to look, and I'm like, this thing's going to go. I deleted it, and I tell you what, guys, this computer's running better than it has since I got it. I'm not kidding. I mean, it's not frozen once. I haven't had a problem. So Mac in general, it doesn't freeze, but obviously when you got something running up your processor to hell, it's going to freeze. I mean, that's sort of obvious. So you definitely cannot blame the computer on that one. Here's something else my hard drive is doing. I've got an external 2 terabyte hard drive, not even a year old. And it was crashing. It wasn't necessarily crashing, but it was showing the files and nothing would actually play. So for the longest time, I thought it was the hard drive doing bad. And I'm like, wait a second, something's wrong here. My hard drive cannot be doing bad, not even a year old. So then I got to looking at Dropbox, and I'm like, And like I said, I got to look in, and the hard drive, after deleting Dropbox, works fine. So, the reason why I'm making this little tutorial slash, I don't know what you'd want to call it. But the reason why I'm doing this is if you're a Mac user and you're having external hard drive problems, and you know your drive's not bad, if you're running Dropbox or any program, okay, if you're running any external program, go into Utilities. Monitor and just do a system search and see what programs are taking up so much CPU. If you see something that's taking up 100 CPU, get rid of that program. That's absolutely ridiculous that there are programs out there that take up that much. And I've talked to people and they said, well, I never had that problem. No, I haven't either on my other machines, but Macs have their own personalities, so take that into consideration before you say, well, no, actually, I'm right. Take it from somebody who knows people. I mean, come on. Here's somebody who's willing to answer your questions. I'm willing to answer almost any question you got about computers or anything dealing with the Mac or GarageBand. I'm an open resource, okay? But let me specify. Just because I'll answer questions does not mean that I will not tell you to do your own research. I won't answer questions if you don't do your own research and find out for yourself. I'm not going to answer a question like, hey, what happens when I open up GarageBand and I see a bunch of projects? Well, why don't you read and see what projects you want to click on? Click on one and explore the program. That's not my choice, what program you click on. What I'm here to tell you is if you want to click on a program, you click on a program, you open it, you explore it, and then if you can't figure it out, let me know. But I should also tell you guys this, I use VoiceOver on the Mac, so I'll be giving you guys keyboard commands instead of mouse commands. I can use the mouse, but I don't want to because I don't really have a need for the mouse. The keyboard does very well for itself, so you'll definitely be getting keyboard commands. If that's a problem, go find somebody else. If that's not a problem, I'm willing to answer any of your questions. So take it or leave it, people. Take it or leave it. So for YouTube.com, this is James Clark saying best regards, guys. I'll talk to y'all on the flip side, and remember, Mac computers beat PC every time. Peace, guys.